Hi, I'm Craig. Welcome to the Treehouse Show. The Treehouse Show is our weekly conversation with the Treehouse community. This episode, we'll be chatting with the developer evangelist, epic podcaster, and principal program manager for the .NET open source project and many other great tools, Scott Hanselman.
Thanks for being here today, Scott. I was wondering if you could tell the students, what's something that you teach here at Treehouse?
I teach C# and Azure, like how to get your website and your ASP.NET website that you write in .NET up into the cloud.
Oh, awesome. Why is C# a good language to start with?
So I like C# because I think it's one of those languages that lets you write anything, anywhere.
Okay.
Like even if you learn C# and become a web developer, you may not know it, but you're also a game developer. And you're an iOS developer, and you can write cloud applications or, you know, tiny applications that run on a Raspberry Pi. You're an anything, anywhere developer. So I think it's a very general language that lets you write anything, anywhere.
That's awesome. How did you get your start in technology?
Well, I was born a young boy on a cold winter's night. When I was 12, I was getting into trouble. And there was a meeting. There's always a meeting.
Sure. The trouble meeting.
Yeah, the trouble meeting. The superintendent was there. It was a district level.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, okay. It was bad. And they knew that I was like an AV club and I was good at computers and stuff. And they let me borrow the Apple II. Not a Apple II. The Apple II. Because it was a poor school. There's only one Apple II. So what they let me do is they let my dad back his truck up to the side of the building on the Friday afternoon, and we basically had permission to steal the Apple II and take it home if it would keep me off the street. And then I had to have it back by 5 o'clock on Sunday, so it was ready for everyone else on Monday, so that no one really knew that we'd stolen it. So it was kind of a don't ask, don't tell kind of a thing. But it kept me from getting into trouble on the weekends.
Wow.
And then I came home some months later and my dad, the truck was gone. He had sold the truck to buy a computer for us.
Oh.
So like that, if a teacher hadn't gotten involved, if the superintendent hadn't said it was okay, if the principal hadn't coordinated the whole thing, if my dad hadn't sold the family car, I don't know what I would be doing. But it wouldn't have been computers. Some kind of white collar crime. That sacrifices on the part of a series of educators along with a degree of Portland Community College.
Oh, great.
Has me here.
Wonderful. What were you doing on that Apple II?
I was playing Oregon Trail and
Conan
the Barbarian, but you know, learning how to actually control robots. Back before Bluetooth, we had these long ribbon cables that would run out of the back of the Apple II into a little tiny robot with a Sharpie, and you'd have on a big piece of butcher paper, and then you'd write logo.
Right.
And then you would draw pictures and spirographs of, you know, it was the first time I could actually see something physical happening, moving a real physical robot. So while we're doing that now, like with Node.js and Bluetooth and tiny robots that we build from scratch, we were doing that 35 years ago, except we had a big, long, tethered ribbon cable.
Right. That's awesome.
Yeah, yeah.
What is something about you that somebody wouldn't know by just looking at you?
That's a good question. I think that a lot of people look at different people and they go, oh, gender or race or age, and they go, eh, this is, you've got a pretty good deal there, right? The thing that I have that is unusual is I'm a type 1 diabetic.
Oh.
So I have to take insulin to manage my blood sugar, and it's a constant up and down. But more interestingly, I run an open source artificial pancreas.
Tell me more about that.
Yeah, I like that. Okay, so you know how you take insulin shots, right?
Yeah.
I don't do that. I have an insulin pump.
Oh, whoa.
So that the insulin is in
here.
And
there's cables.
Right, and there's cables that are physically plugged into me. I won't lift my shirt, but that's plugged in all the time, and there's a whole system right there. Okay, so that's delivery. This is the write only.
Okay.
Okay. Then I have a Bluetooth implanted system. If you can, it's actually implanted in my side there with a battery. It's talking Bluetooth.
You're running on Bluetooth.
I'm running on Bluetooth.
Wow.
Bluetooth low energy. And so there's my read. That shows my blood sugar. You see it's going up a little bit because I just had tacos.
Right.
This is a very old pump that speaks radio frequency. Doesn't speak Bluetooth because it was made before Bluetooth.
Okay.
I've got my phone where I have my an open source application called Loop that runs my blood sugar.
What was that called again?
Loop.
Loop. Okay.
L-O. If you go into Google for Loop Kit, you can learn about it. I need this to tell the pump to deliver if I want it to happen automatically, but this doesn't support Bluetooth.
Okay.
Right? So this is called a Riley link. It is a Bluetooth to radio frequency bridge.
Okay.
This allows this pump to speak Bluetooth because I can go and talk to it. This is now blinking. This is talking Bluetooth to the pump.
To the pump.
It's the proxy
right.
for the okay. pump, which is now talking radio frequency to the pump. So I've Bluetooth, we've Bluetoothed the 20-year-old pump. So I get Bluetooth data here that goes over to here, closes the loop.
Okay.
Look at my blood sugar, make a small change. So it's kind of like Tesla autopilot.
That's
a... It's not perfect. It keeps you in the lane.
Sure.
But of course, if you have to make a hard left turn, you're going to die. So I still have to do a lot of manual work. But this is part of a whole group of people, about a big community of open source developers. The things you can go and Google for are Loop and Night Scout. But the great thing to do is check out the hashtag #WeAreNotWaiting. This is the diabetes community that I'm a part of, and we're not waiting for a cure. We'll just make it ourselves with code.
That is amazing.
Thanks.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Thanks for watching The Treehouse Show. To get in touch with the show, reach out to me on Twitter or hit us up in the Treehouse community. See you next time.